Lita says, yeah, we've forgotten all about you. Sorry about that. You were crumpled in a corner. Huh? Where am I? Oh, we're in a new place for you to play. Hide and go seek. Just don't jump down that hole over there. Oh, good, says Ratis. You regained consciousness. Yes, obviously. I was playing hide and seek, and when I find Jimmy... Oh no! Jimmy is in trouble! Everyone, please, save Jimmy! He was trying to protect me, and a fat guy attacked him with a glittering force, and... Don't worry, Ruti says. Jimmy's okay. Lucius says, that kind of injury was a good lesson for that brat. Oh, come on, Lucius. You were genuinely worried about him. Don't come off like that. I want to see Jimmy! Douglas says, do whatever Princess wants. Let's go back to the village. Good idea, says Avon. I'm sure everyone's worried to death. Oh, if I put it like that, to death. Jimmy! Lita's yelling. Oh. Lita, are you alright? You worried me sick. I'm sorry. You got hurt a lot because of me. No, it's not your fault. Besides, I'm very strong. I got hurt because I was careless. Otherwise, I would never let such a fat ass... Ouch! Don't get up yet, says Lita. Too late. I'll take care of you, so please stay in bed. Ugh. Ouch! Don't treat me so violently. She doesn't know her strength. Who's this, Douglas? You're watching through the window? Hey, hey! You are a lucky guy, Jimmy. But, Lucius, it was the right decision to bring Jimmy along. Yeah. He has been keeping people at a distance, like a porcupine, by using the power to make himself disappear, but... He's started to learn how to protect someone important. I'm glad. Really, says Ratis. I have to hang on, too, says Avon. What does that mean? Serene says, I don't know how to thank you. Chief Godal says, the attackers are gone, and the monster disappeared. It's all thanks to you guys. No, we didn't do much, says Avon. It's thanks to Jimmy, Lita, you all, and Scotia, the pure lake spirit. Avon says, it's been taking so long. I wonder what Douglas is doing with Lucius. Ruti says, they're probably trying to bury their past. Douglas says, come on, are you really going to do it? Lucia says, it's been 5 years since then. I've been working so hard to improve my skills to beat you. Faster, sharper, and farther than you. I want to see the accomplishment of my training. Douglas says, okay, alright, try me. You can use your thunder sword if you want. No thanks. Let's make this match more exciting. Are you up to a bet? Lucia says, bet? If you win, I'll give you this thunder sword. But if I win instead, you have to lend a hand to Avon. Lucia says, you can tell by his eyes he's a good intent, or he has a good intent. I'm happy to cooperate with him. Are you messing around with me? I'm more than serious, says Douglas. Are you okay with doing something you are going to regret? Douglas says, I won't lose anything, either way. Only this one time, says Lucius. That's enough, says Douglas. They both chop each other's heads off. Dead. Douglas says, Lucius, you really improved yourself. Are you being sarcastic? Darn it. My arm feels numb, says Lucius. You were much sharper and faster than me. If we were to hit each other at the same time, I would have lost. But I won my bet. Avon says, are you two done with your business? Yep, we are done, says Douglas. Come on, Lucius. You've got something you want to say, right? Shush. Don't tell me what to do. Avon, I have a special favor to ask you. A favor? Says Avon. I want you to allow me to accompany you. I'm pretty confident in my skill with a sword and spirit spells. I'm sure I can help you during your journey. Accompany me? To what do we owe this surprise? Well, we did a little bet, says Douglas. Humph. Let's set the bet aside, says Lucius. I've been thinking about something while I was an adventurer. I've wanted to make the best use of my swordsmanship. I understand that you're carrying such a big mission. I would really appreciate it if you could let me help you on your mission. Avon says, I don't quite catch what's going on, but if you can come with us, my journey will become much easier. If anything, it's me who should be asking you for a favor. Ruti says, I feel reassured. Thank you. Thanks to you too, says Lucius. Jimmy says, why Lucius? It's not fair that you're going to leave without saying anything to me. Or why, comma, Lucius, I guess. Jimmy, she just says. I know. You were going to go on a journey with them, right? I wish I could go with you, but Lucia says you are not fully recovered yet. You need to recuperate and get better. I'm sick of this boring village. Avon says, you say that, but you are always playing with Lita. It's because anyhow, I'm worried about Lucius. You appear to be cool, but you're really a caring person. You're so shaky that I can't take my eyes off of you. Lucia says, you are such a brat who is never at a loss for words. But I admit that I still have a long ways to go. I was just forced to realize that. I'll aim higher and try harder. So, you also hung in there to become a whole man. He was only half a man before. Jimmy says, I'm already a whole man, though, but I'll become a better man than now. Yeah, I look forward to that. See ya, Jimmy, says Avon. Douglas says, don't cause any more mischief. Ruti says, I hope I'll see you soon. I think she was going to say something else. I want to talk to everybody again. Get back here. She looks back again. What was waiting for Avon and company at Quitt was the rumored mysterious monster, quote unquote. Avon received the sacred treasure from Scotia. He could get it with the help of Douglas, who is reunited in Valkd and skilled swordswoman of his old friend. She has a name, too. However, the journey to search for the sacred treasures has just begun. Avon and Rutis were to return to the Grand Cathedral in Valkd to report what had happened. Alright, we're like right outside the village still. We're gonna just walk right back in there. And go check in with everybody. I just want to see Delipede. Or Delipede. Sacred treasure entrusted by Scotia called the Right Leg of Bardas. Cool. Together we'll form a whole Bardas. Alright, let's just see if you don't need to buy anything else, really. Just to see if they say anything different. I doubt they would. They're not going to say anything different when I go into the merchant dialogue. Let's just try back here. Nope. All right. Serene says, thank you for everything, everyone. I can't thank you enough, but I want to give you this book to show my appreciation. Excellent, Swordsmaster 7. Lucius, come back here anytime. You too. Please come visit us after you're done with your task. I guess Lucius come back here anytime, and you too is Avon? Book. Excellent. Swordmaster 7, happy to receive. Thank you for everything you've done for us. I can't do much, but at least let us do something in return. 3,000 rows. Nice. Lucia says, are you sure? Wasn't that the monster in the lake just a misunderstanding after all? You are a benefactor of the village. I must give you at least this much. Will you accept it? Lucia says, okay, I'll accept it then. We'll take care of that boy in this village, so feel okay about leaving for the journey, Lucius. Thank you for everything. I wonder if we can go back to the shrine and if these people are still collapsed over here. Nope, they're gone. And it's closed up as well. Alright. Oops. Thank you. We used two of them, so now we got 9. I like when the cat actually picks up something we can really use. So is the boat still here? It is. Oh. Okay, there's our other one. We got 10 again. I wonder when the boat will set out next. It's too much hustle. Too much hustle and hassle. I like that little flare there with the flute. I heard about you saving Lita. Thanks for your work. Ah, Oscar. Lita was safe, and we can resume collecting placer gold. It's all thanks to you guys. Thank you very much. I suppose I'm never gonna find out what placer gold is. Old woman, whatever her name is. Oh, we're full now. The boy came to me and asked me where the Scotia is. But because I told him that he would be able to figure out soon, he got sore and left. Ha ha ha. He'll be surprised if he finds out that where he is now is the Scotia. If he's on the boat, I thought he was off in the village. Is he on the boat somewhere? We gotta find him then. Oh, there he is. Yep, he is on the Scotia. Jimmy, I haven't seen the Scotia yet. Even though I asked around, no one told me about it. They all told me to look forward to the time of departure. You're on it, dude. I don't understand how no one realized this is actually a boat. I'm a nurse. Jimmy got better because I looked after him. Right, Jimmy? I couldn't stand her following me around, even to the bathroom, but thanks to her, I got better. Mr. Oscar said that he will let me ride on the Scotia next time he goes to collect placer gold. With Jimmy, of course. I'm so excited. Awesome. Our card players are here. Card games are fun to play when we don't bet on roses. Robert says, what are you talking about? The loser has to give a shoulder rub. Okay, okay. Shoulder rub, right? But my shoulders are fine, so can you rub my back? Ugh. Jerk, says Robert. Henry says, when I think about it, it's so ungrateful to use roses given by the blessing of Scotia for gambling. As soon as we stopped betting with money, Henry started to have the game of his life. Is it that Scotia's taking his side because he's had change of heart? No, I think it's just luck. It's an unrelated thing. Alright. We got Swordsmaster 7. So, where are we going now? Back? Back to Valkd? Well, I don't remember the way, but it shouldn't be that complicated. What's this way? Probably not this way. The empty chest. What you got? You got crap. I was gonna say we should rest. But we're at full anyway. Well, that's where it came from. Okay, so there's... Oh, that's a dead end. That thing looks pretty funky looking. Thanks. Thank you, my feline friend. East is Valkd, west is Quitt, which just came from... it says 65 milos. But when we're next to the town, it says 100 and something milos. Well, I'm sure we're not going to Pregon Cave, so we're going east to Valkd. Oh! A girl's voice yells, "Eek!" Uh-oh. We have a damsel in distress. She's being chased by one of those pokey things. Ow! She ran right into a wall. "It's Shannon!" yells Avon. Lucius yells, "Yah!" "He's fast," says Rutis. "As expected," Douglas says. Avon yells, "Shannon, are you all right?" Douglas says, "You're the girl who suffered the poison gas in New Boren." "Avon." "Shannon, why are you here?" "I was looking for Mile. I have been thinking a lot. I still can't believe he's gone. I don't want to disagree with fate, but I just feel he's still alive." "We didn't find the body. He could still be alive." I mean, he was bloody, but no one took his pulse or listened to his heartbeat or anything. "Shannon," says Avon. "That's why I was being chased by a monster." Oh, she passed out again. "Hey, Shannon," yells Avon. Rutis says, "Valkd is only a short distance away. Let's carry her to the Grand Cathedral and get her examined." "Okay." Oracle Kalian says, "The reason why she fainted was because of hunger and fatigue." She fainted because she was hungry," says Avon. Why is he saying that? Is he being sarcastic? Lucia says, "Well, I'm glad that she isn't hurt." "That's right. She'll be fine after she lies down and takes a good rest." "Thank you, Kalian," says Rutis. "Don't mention it. This is my job. Please excuse me now." "You're not excused. Get back here, young man." "Shannon," says Avon, how come you can believe that Mile is still alive?" "I can't believe it even though I want to." Matisse says, "But Shannon might be right because his body hasn't been found yet either." "There you go, Rutice. You're on my wavelength exactly. According to Sage Gawain, a copious pool of blood was left there." but there is still a possibility of him being alive. He even says, I'm scared to be disappointed. I don't want to find out that he's been dead this whole time after I've spent so much energy looking for him. I'm such a weak person. Avon, says Retis. Douglas whispers to her, just leave him alone. But, Douglas, it's hard to face your own weakness. But it's something he has to overcome by himself. Avon says, well, let's go to the chapel. We have to report Sir Kroar. Is it Kroar? Kroar. Kroar? How do I say that? Sir Kroar, that we've obtained the sacred treasure. Good song. Shannon is sleeping, breathing peacefully. Shannon, I hope she would decide to return to her hometown after this. Alright, are we going to look around and talk to everybody again? I suppose so. Sosie says, I'm in trouble. It looks like my butler is not in the Grand Cathedral. What should I do now? Avon says, I think you should stay here and wait for him. I think you should stay in the same place to avoid missing each other. I see. That makes sense. I will wait for him here then. Oops. The top of the church is hustling. They are pressing the sins of avarice hard. Phew, I think I can gain some time. The top of the church is hustling. Miss Alessia wrote me a letter, but something was wrong in that letter. She usually updates me on Emel and others, but she didn't write anything about it this time. Did anything happen there? Yeah, it's a long story, which we're obviously not getting into. That goes... I want to go home. I want to see my grandma. Too bad for you. How long do we have to remain here? We can't just leave our store back home like this any longer. I think we'll be alright if we believe in Bardas, but I'm worried about my farm. Alright, that's that room. These people are meditating, I'm sorry, but could you please leave? They are praying for Bardas. I don't want to leave. I want to harass people. A wide path and a narrow path. They say that a path to truth is severe and hard. That must be why it's called a narrow path. If it's severe and hard, it's the proof of going to truth. But it depends on what the person believes is truth. Okay then. Is this... Oh, we can't look at these books. It's not the, I want to say resource room. Excuse me. Right. Whew. Hold on 1 second, guys. Okay. The number of the worshippers of the Grand Cathedral have decreased rapidly since the monster infestation. I can totally sense how serious the situation is. Totally. Sunday school is held only in the Holy Capital. All children should have an equal opportunity for education, but it seems difficult to have Sunday school at the other towns because of the limited budget. No thanks. Are they your friends? They all look competent. Oh, the complete incompetence. Wait, I'm gonna go down there. It's all locked. Oh, Bardas, why is this happening to me? Please save your loyal servant. You're not a loyal servant. Anything but. I wonder if someday we can open these doors. All these chests. So cool. Oh. All we do is our cat finds things that we don't need. Well, yeah, I'm gonna go up. I'm pretty sure nothing's gonna be available. An item. Because of the flood of the monster in the highways, I can't return to the village. I have no choice but to ask to stay overnight here. On some pretext or other, the church is reliable. Some pretext. Alright, so that's most of everything. Well, that goes... Alright. I think that's where we're going next. Let me just... Yeah, we're going that way. I like how the footsteps change when you're walking on the rug. I like the way it sounds. Where's the way? Yeah, the two. Yeah, we can get this one. These are all the monster books. It is said that there used to be a room in the basement of the cathedral which people were not allowed to enter. It's also said that the only person who was able to go in the room was the successive supreme priests. Now the former supreme priest passed away, the only person who knows the secret could be Lord Velius. Okay. I don't like him knowing things like that, but what can you do? In the Book of Life, it recorded the sacred spells not only to control animals' minds, but also to enhance potential. I wonder if that's the reason why the monsters have gotten stronger. It could be. So these are all the monster books. 1 through 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Oh no. This one's not one. Six. 5. Well, here's 7. And 8. Okay. And obviously, 1, 2, 3, 4. They say that the monsters entered the town from the entrance. Fortunately, they were driven away by the paladin, though. The barrier should have been set around the outside wall. What paladin? The monsters couldn't have overcome it. Whether the power of the barrier was weakened or the power of the monsters got stronger, either way, it's definitely a serious matter. Most definitely. I don't want to go here yet. Where's the other... Oh, I was like, where's the other resource room? Right here. The old documents written in the sacred characters say that the world used to be one vast land. After light and darkness went to sleep, a huge disaster attacked the land. Because of the disaster, it is said that Elfilden was distinguished as the land that the gods sleep. Doesn't make a lot of sense. The land that the gods sleep? I'm not sure whether the old documents are telling the truth or not. It'll all be cleared when someone sees to the end of the land. Someone sees to the end of the land? We've read that. And then this one we've read also. Yeah. Alright, we're gonna go talk to what's his name. So if you go up here, let me just... I just want to make sure I've talked to everybody. Well, that just goes up here. This is the... main area. Yeah, that kid? Okay. Yeah, this is back to where we pretty much started. Who's this? Oh. Priest Quar. You're back, Aven. I know. Is it true that you took someone who was sick? Yeah, but it wasn't necessary to worry about. More than that, Aven explained to him what happened at the village of Quitt and showed him the sacred treasure Delipied. Sacred treasure Delipied? The quick right foot of God. You must have successfully gained the Tress of Scotia. However, I didn't think that the Octum's apostles had already extended their hand towards the four great spirits. Rutis says their plan is to make bad use of the Book of Life, in which the Durga's sacred mystique is recorded. I suggest that we should all get the sacred treasures before they take any action. Where is the next shrine located? Says Aven. According to the sequence of the village you saw on the Truth Island, the next one is the Shrine of Eden in Garden Hill. Garden Hill? Says Aven. Douglas says, the north of Newborn is a mountain region. Garden Hill is an unconventional village on top of the mountain. Unconventional, huh? Near Newborn, Aven says. That means we will have to cross the continent in the east. Rutu says, let's take a boat from Theta to Beloa. We can go to Newborn via Guia. Alright, so we're going to go Theta. Before that, Quar says, we have to take care of the problem of rare metal. The plant manager of Guia agreed to produce a sword of rare metal. I want you to stop by at the factory in Guia before going to the Eden Shrine. Alright, says Aven. Rutis, you'll be able to see Ruka. Yeah. Quara says, and after Eden is the Neftis Shrine. It's located near Ort Village in the southeast of Notos region. I assume you know the area better than I do. Yes, says Aven. The ruins are in the back of our lookout cottage. I used to play there with Mile. I had no idea there was a shrine underground, though. Neither did I. Quara says, the last one is Zar Shrine. After receiving the treasures from Eden and Niftis, I want you to come back to Valkd once. Or at once. It's because there's some complicating situation. I understand, says Avon. We'll be back once we've received two of the treasures. Thank you. By the way, I assume people behind you are adventurers by the way they look. Douglas says, forgive our rudeness for not introducing ourselves right away. I'm Douglas. I belong to the Adventurer Guild. Same here. I'm Lucius. I've heard your brave names. Please help Avon on his journey. Certainly, says Douglas. We'll do our best, Lucius says. Rutis, do you think you will be able to find your own way? Quara says. I'm still lost, but I know my journey will overlap with Avon's journey. I will try to keep up with him to the end of his journey. It's good to help each other since both of you are on the way to find your path. Then be careful on your way. May the light and spirits bless your journey. First of all, head to Garden Hill. There's an old ruined town north of New Boren across the Big Hazy Valley. May Bardas protect you. Why, thank you. I don't know if these people have anything new to say after that, even. Let's just check with her just in case. Probably not. She said that before, right? I think? Alright, so before we go, I'm going to read Swordmaster 7, so if anyone wants to tune out, now would be the time, since we're just going to end the video after that. And of course I'll make a separate video of me reading them. I'll put them up when they're all complete, when I have them all. War Chronicles, Swordsmaster Zamza, Volume 7, An Unexpected Encounter. Who are you? Zamza asked as he reached for his favorite sword and threw down the sheath. He recovered the rhythm of his breath. Ha ha ha, I am Witchcraft Master Tempest. I have allegiance with the Dark Apostles. Consider that as a little hello from me. Well, that was a nice, rude greeting. Tempest didn't seem to like Zamza's responses. He narrowed his eyes to Zamza. I wanted you to become my puppet under my powers, but you have such a strong mind. But you alone mean nothing to me at this point. What do you mean? Zamza can't understand the situation, and it was an honest question. But Tempest frowned as if his feeling of victory was somehow tarnished. He told a shocking story. All of the men in your army are already under my control, just like that man lying on the floor there. What? I guess you're surprised, huh? Tempest smiled satisfactorily and glared at Zamza. The 10 sages were planning on having a truce, but I will have you continue with the battle. You got the letter, did you not? You control the old men, too? At dawn, the Red Tribe people who are now my zombies will advance into Milligan's forces, whether you like it or not. You have no way to stop them, except, of course, defeating me. Before Tempest completed the sentence, a flash of metal sliced where he stood. Zamza had attacked. My, my. You look so calm, but such a hot head. Why did you do such a thing? I have no obligation to explain to you, but I feel sorry for you. I'll tell you a little bit. Huh, that's it. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.